Hello everybody and welcome back to our brand new episode of the NASCAR Heat 5 Career Mode. I hope you're all having a great day. Today we go racing at Indianapolis for the Brickyard 400, and today is the one season anniversary of our first win in our Cup Series career. Last season out, we got our first win at the Brickyard 400, so hopefully we can back that up here today. As actually start this episode off showing our driver relationships, you see right now Joey Logano, currently the worst one. We have been kind of having some run-ins with him recently, and you can see there that he is pretty annoyed with us right now, but we still got a little bit of buffer room, but we definitely got to be careful around Joey, because I've said over the last few episodes things have been kind of ramping up with him. We've made some contact with him recently, but hopefully we can kind of keep it calm in this episode, and hopefully we can just be ahead of him the whole time. That would definitely be preferred, and we know we're going to have speed at Indianapolis. We run well here in the past NASCAR Heat games, NASCAR Heat 4. We've picked up a win here, so hopefully we can do the same here today in the Brickyard 400 to get our second Brickyard 400 win already now, as we're going to come through though into the Xfinity Series race here for the Indiana 250, where I decided I was actually going to be in the 20 car for this race. No truck race again. There's been a bit of a break for the truck series, but I'm sure that we'll have a truck race in the next episode now, as we are going to get ready to go green here in Indianapolis in this number 20 all-star car for Joe Gibbs Racing. Now, as we got underway here in Indianapolis on pole, it was Ross Chastain for the Indiana 250 there, as you see me already passing the 39 of Ryan Sieg, as well as our teammate in the 19 of Brandon Jones. And Brandon Jones, I think, is a driver that we could definitely look out for at some point here in the future to be moving up to the Cup Series at some point in this career mode here, as we're side by side now as we go down this back straightaway. But we are going to continue to move our way forwards now, as we have that draft from the cars up ahead from that 22 of Austin Cindric, and we would be able to run him down, actually get up the inside of him here as we came through down the front straightaway using that draft from the 98 of Todd Gilliland, and that would allow me to get a clear of the 22 of Austin Cindric. But it kind of got quiet after I was able to make that move. I would run down the 98 of Gilliland, but we came through to the final lap of this race already, and you can see I'd just gone nowhere as I actually tried to make a move up the inside of Gilliland and move up into P3, but I just couldn't quite make it happen. Very hard to pass at times, especially when the tires wear out at a track like Indianapolis. I've struggled with that in the past, and I was struggling with it right here as I just could not make the bottom work against Todd. So we come through out of turn two, nearly clipping that safer barrier now as Cindric tries to put on some pressure from behind. We know Cindric, he will be in the Cup Series in the career mode next season in the number 21 car for Wood Brothers Racing. Now as we come through turns three for the final time here in the Indiana 250, Ross Chastain has dominated this race. Second place belongs to Allgaier as they go down into four. Todd Gilliland, who's had an incredible rookie season so far, not moving up into the Cup Series, but that could definitely change now as we go down this front straightaway. Ross Chastain is going to come through to pick up the victory here in Indianapolis. Allgaier second, Gilliland third, and myself in the fourth position here in Indianapolis. So a solid way to start off the Brickyard 400 weekend. Can't complain about a top 5 finish in the Xfinity Series race. We haven't done a lot of Xfinity Series races this year, but we've done a pretty solid job now. And as I mentioned, Todd Gilliland earlier not being signed anywhere yet for next season. We got breaking news coming in right after the Xfinity race, where Ryan Newman's replacement has been announced, and it will be Todd Gilliland moving up to the 6th car next season. There you see Todd Gilliland will be replacing the retired Ryan Newman at the end of this season. He will be moving up from the Stuart Haas Racing 98 car. So there you have it now, as Gilliland has had a very strong rookie season, and he will be moving up along with Austin Cindric and Zane Smith into next season's rookie class now in the Cup Series. So that's going to be a very strong rookie class, to say the least. Personally, I think Zane Smith is going to have the best opportunity to win Rookie of the Year in the next season of the career mode, because McLaren coming into NASCAR, as you guys know, that's where he will be going in the career mode. I think McLaren is going to be the best opportunity. They are bringing in a lot of funding onto the NASCAR side to be a strong competitor right out of the gate. So you're definitely going to have to watch out for that Zane Smith and Eric Jones McLaren duo next season here in the career mode. Now, as we come through to the end of our qualifying lap, the goal was to hit a 52.386, and we will shatter that goal with 51.344. Do not go pole, but we do qualify P4 here in the Big Machine Vodka 400 at the Brickyard now. So a very strong effort now, as you see up in front of us on pole. It's actually going to be our teammate of Denny Hamlin, then another teammate of Kyle Busch in second, Eric Jones P3, who's been running very, very well recently here in the career mode. So definitely going to have to keep an eye out for Eric Jones here in the coming races now, as he's really picking it up towards the playoffs. There's on the bottom of the field, we got Timmy Hill. So definitely setting up for an interesting race in the one season anniversary, like I mentioned, of our first career win. Now, as you see, David Reagan's car is very fast today. He had a pretty solid qualifying effort now as we're getting ready to go for this Brickyard 400. But fresh off the news of Todd Gilliland going to that sixth car, we know Ryan Newman will be retiring at the end of the season in the career mode. He is still trying to make the playoffs now, as it's going to be a tough fight for him, but he still has a chance now. As you see, Hamlin, not only is he on the pole, but he's also having a stellar weekend, which tells me right off the bat that Hamlin's going to have a very fast car, and he's going to be very tough to pass as well as very tough to beat now, as we're going to get ready to go green for the Brickyard 400 and try to defend our Brickyard 400 victory from last season. Now, as we are underway, Denny Hamlin and Kyle Busch lead the way to the green flag as myself and Eric Jones find ourselves on this second row. As behind us, we got Keselowski as well as Martin Truex Jr. side by side as we go down into turn one. And you guys definitely have been wondering, where am I going to be going next season in the career mode? I can tell you an announcement on that is coming very soon. I'm trying to get all of the silly season announcements out of the way before we get to the playoffs, so we can just solely focus on the playoffs. Now, as we come through out of turn two behind that two car of Brad Keselowski side by side with Elliott, but I use the drive to get clear of Elliott and dive now to the inside of the two car of Keselowski, make it three wide with Keselowski as well as Eric Jones, but actually back out of it as we go down towards turns three. Way too early to be sending it up the inside three wide like that, so I decided to just back out, make sure we didn't cause any mayhem. Now, as we go into turn four, still side by side between Jones as well as Brad Keselowski's Hamlin and Kyle Busch trying to drive away from the field very early on. Now, as I'm going to get into the back of the 88, trying to push him forwards there, as I nearly got into the right rear of him and hooked him instead. Now, as we go down this front stretch, completing the first and opening lap of the Brickyard 400. Martin Truex Jr. just behind myself there in that sixth position. So right now, all four Joe Gibbs Racing cars in the top six, and then the two affiliates running a ways behind us, like Harrison Burton as well as Bubba Wallace. Now, as we came through down this back straightaway, pushing Jones ahead now of the two of Keselowski on the second lap, continuing to push him so I can try to get clear of Keselowski into turn three. Sure enough, we do clear that two car of Keselowski and now settle in the fourth position. And now I was realizing we're definitely quicker than this 88 of Jones, who qualified third but doesn't quite seem to have third place speed here as we come through out of turn four, continuing to get on his back bumper and just give him a little bit of help. But we came through now on lap three out of turn two, and I decided, you know what, we have enough speed to get past him, so I get right on that left door now as we open up that gap a little bit in terms of width between myself and him, and we go down towards turn three, and we are now going to clear Eric Jones for P3 and try to run down second place of Kyle Busch. Truex moves into fourth, so now it's Joe Gibbs Racing 1, 2, 3, 4. So far we are just completely in another level in terms of just dominating this race as a team right now as we come through out of the corner. So Truex, though, he was definitely showing more speed than myself at this moment in the race as we came through to start lap four. So I realized that he was going to have the speed to get past me. We came through out of turn one. I go a little bit wide. Truex, he's right on the back of me. So I decide, you know what, we're just going to be generous to him into turn two, let him go. And now we drift back down into P4. And I decided we could get right up on that back bumper now of Martin Truex Jr. So we come through on lap five, trying to push him ahead, but you can see that the 11 and the 18 are just long gone from everybody at this point. I'm myself pushing Truex as much as I can, and we were still not closing anything on these guys in front of us. That was definitely a slight concern now as we go into turn three on lap six. As you can see, Hamlin, he's opening up the gap between himself and Kyle Busch, but I hit the apron there for a moment and kind of unsettled the car, but fortunately we would be able to hang on to it and keep with Truex as I continue to try and push him. But we came through getting a caution now late in stage one. Could not find what brought the caution now, but that would end stage one about four laps earlier. So we would all get ready though to come into the pit lane for two cans of fuel as well as four tires. Are very easy to call to make now as we get P4 in this first and opening stage. Solid car, guys, but oh my god, the 11 and the 18 are in a league of their own right now, and I have no idea what it's going to take to get them, but we definitely need to tighten it up on the long run. There you heard my feedback to the team right there now as we're going to get ready now to get back going in for the start of the second stage now as you see the rest of the order. So right now we got Ryan Blaney actually was the reason for the caution, and I can confirm he is out of this race. He has a lot of points above that cut line right now. He has not won the season, so he's not locked into the playoffs, but he has enough points to where that should not really impact him too much now as we get ready to go green for the start of the second stage, which is now underway. Denny Hamlin and Kyle Busch lead the way back to stage two as it it's still a Joe Gibbs Racing. 1, 2, 3, 4 behind us. We got Jones as well as Brad Keselowski side by side on row number 3. As I go a little bit wider there through turns 1 now, as I tightened up the car quite a bit on the pit stop, hoping that on the long run it'd be a little bit better. I couldn't really get a great feel for it there at the end of stage 1 because it ended like 4 laps early, but it's still, I could kind of feel the car freeing up just a little bit. But we got cleared by the 88 of Eric Jones now as we go down this back straightaway. Harvick was up my inside, but I get clear of him, and now I send it up the inside of the 88 of Eric as we go down towards turn 3. Truex now side by side with Kyle Busch. We know how much speed is in that 18 car and the 11 car, so if we can get ourselves at least in front of one of them, which would be Kyle Busch in this scenario, we'll be looking pretty good now, as Martin Truex Jr., he's doing his best to try and do exactly that now as we exit turn 4. So I decide, you know what, instead of helping Kyle, I'm just going to take full advantage here and send it 3 wide down the front straightaway with our teammates now, as it's a great battle going on between us three. Truex backs out of it as we go into turn 1. We're still side by side with the 18 of Kyle Busch though, as we exit the corner into the left rear quarter panel. Truex now goes 3 wide with us as we go down towards turns 2, and now Kyle Busch gets clear, Truex gets clear, and after all of that, it's the same situation as before. Truex side by side with Kyle Busch, so we continue though to follow Truex now up the inside of that 18, and now Truex clears Kyle Busch through turn 3 into turn 4, and now I'm trying to follow through as well, but I'm just having a very tough time. Some contact made between myself and Kyle as we go down this front straightaway using that draft from Truex. Myself and Kyle both fighting hard to use that draft from Truex to clear each other as we go side by side down into turn 1 here in the Brickyard 400. Hamlin loving the rearview mirror just view now as he sees everybody battling behind him now as we exit turn 1 going into turn 2, still battling it out with Kyle Busch now as I just cannot quite clear him as we exit the corner, pushing up the track a little bit, but we got to give him the room now, and we continue side by side here down the back straightaway. So Kyle doing everything he can to get clear and hold on, but I just don't have enough on that bottom lane to be able to get ahead of him, so I was just doing everything I could to try and maybe clear him on the entrance of turn 3, because I knew if he could stay on the outside just like that right there, that turn 4 was just a lost cause now as we come through in to the corner. Hamlin continues to drive away, and we're going to exit turn 4. More contact there with the 18, but Kyle finally is going to clear me, so we drift back down into 4th place. Harvick actually was able to stay with all of us after that battle, but I actually said, you know what, I'm going to go back to the inside now of Kyle and see if we can make something happen into turn 1 with 11 laps to go in the stage, but it just wasn't working now as we come through out of turn 2, trying to make sure I did not get into the 18, but Kyle finally settles in. I actually go to the outside here down the back straightaway, side draft him a little bit now as we go down toward turn 3. I couldn't make the bottom work, so I said, you know what, we might as well try to make the top work as we go into the corner, and I felt like that went even worse than the bottom for me, so I had no idea at this point how I was going to be able to pass Kyle Busch, but he would put the attack now to Martin Truex Jr. on lap 5. He gets up the inside, they would be pretty even down this back straightaway now as Hamlin continues to just dominate this second stage just like he did in stage 1, as we're opening up the gap now between ourselves as to 5th place of Kevin Harvick. But I get up the inside of Truex following Kyle Busch, and I was curious to see maybe if it would be easier to pass Truex here, so we come through side by side into turn 4, trying to hold on to P3 from him now, as he's going to be the same situation as Kyle, where he's able to stay ahead, but it does not matter because of caution comes out once again. Could not find what brought the caution out, but this would force us into a late stage restart. Looks like Timmy Hill actually was the reason for the caution, but everybody's staying out, and we'll get ready to go green here for a late stage 2 restart. I don't know what it's going to take to be able to pass those guys on the long run, guys. Like, we can do it maybe on the first couple of laps, but it's so hard after everybody gets single file. There you hear me on the radio once again telling the team just kind of how hard it was to pass at this moment in the race now, as we are back underway. JGR still first through fourth, and on that row 3 behind us, it's SHR with Kevin Harvick as well as Cole Custer, who's really picked up his performance lately in the career mode now as we come through out of turn 1. Kyle Busch did not get the greatest launch, and that was not what we want, because now Harvick, it gets to my inside, so we're a little bit vulnerable now to lose a position, and sure enough, we do lose a spot as we exit turn 2, and up the inside goes another SHR car of the rookie of Chase Briscoe. Here's a go down this back straightaway, closing in on the back of the 4. We slice to the inside just in front of the 14 of Briscoe, side by side with Harvick, and already clear into turn 3 now as Truex continues to put the fight to Kyle Busch. They've battled it out quite a bit before that caution came out there in stage 2 as we go down into turn 4. Hamlin continuing to just put on a dominant performance as we exit the corner, and I'm doing my best to maybe put the attack again to Kyle Busch. You see how much of a run we have, and we gotta at least try it now. So we get to the inside right on that left door for a second, trying to side draft as much as I can, and we clear Kyle because we have so much draft into turn 1 now, as he's going to have the run back on the outside. I'm sliding up the track nearly into the 19 and barely up in front of the 18 of Kyle Busch. So now we finally pass the 18 of Kyle Busch, take over P3, and like I said on the radio, it's a lot easier to make these passes right off the bat on a restart, because once everybody gets single file, it's just so much harder now as I get right back to the back of the 19 of Truex and try to push him, but then I clip the apron through turn 3 on lap 11. We go for a bit of a slide that allows Truex to open up the gap a little bit, and now Kyle tries to get to my inside as we exit turn 4 now, as I fortunately still had the draft from Martin Truex Jr., but you can kind of see me slipping and sliding there on the exit of turn 4 as well, but we were just trying to now close that gap back up to Truex, which we successfully would do. We would get within about 2 car lengths or so as we came through to 3 laps to go now in stage 2. Hamlin, well, once again driving away at this point as we get to the back of Truex. I knew if I tried to make a pass on the inside right here, it was not going to be successful, so I decided to just chill behind him, and we come through out of turn 4 on lap 12, and you can see the car just going for a big slide there, and that allows Kyle Busch to get on the attack and get up my inside, coming to 2 laps to go in the second stage, so we're pretty even at the line. We have that draft from Truex, hoping to stay clear of Kyle into turn 1. Unfortunately, does not happen, so we now go into turn 1 and give up the position to Kyle Busch and now drift down into P4. Still a solid run overall for us going right now as we come through to 2 laps to go, or down the back straightaway with 2 laps to go on the stage. Kyle already putting the attack to the inside of Martin Truex Jr., and really, I think Kyle Busch is Hamlin's largest competition right now in this race, as you can see me sliding again through turns 3, so we definitely need to make some more adjustments at the end of this second stage. There, as we clip the apron out of turns 4, and we hit the outside wall pretty heavily there as we damage the right side of the car, as you can see the damage on your screen now, as that opens up an opportunity for that big pack of cars right behind us trying to swallow us up as we start the final lap of the second stage as we go down into turn 1. Sorry guys, the car just got so loose right there and I just could not hang on to it. There, you heard myself on the radio very quick now as we come through into turn 2, and I just said the car got loose, I could not hang on to it. We pretty much just chased it up to the wall after I hit that apron, of course, as we exit the corner. Briscoe closing that gap to the back of myself, Reagan, Custer, Logano, Harvick, all back there together in that group of cars as we try to just hold them off for another half a lap as Hamlin leads away into turn 3 for the final time here in the second stage, as we just got to get through these few corners without making a mistake, and we will be able to hold on to P4 here in stage 2 as we dive down into turn 4, where we hit the apron on the last lap, putting us in the wall. Fortunately, doesn't happen this time. The car was still just a little bit looser on the exit of turn 4, but we hang on now as Briscoe actually gets a bit of a run to the back of us, but it's not going to be enough now as we are able to stay clear of him as we come through to cross the line for the fourth position here in stage 2, but definitely some work to be done on the car if we were going to have a chance to win. Honestly, what would be the perfect case scenario is if we could just get a short run at the end of this race and maybe have a chance to put some fresh tires on it. Doubt that's going to happen, but that would definitely help us a lot. Definitely got to tighten it up a little bit more, guys. It's bearable now, but yeah, if we want to have a chance to do anything, we need to be still a little bit tighter. There, you heard my feedback to the team right there now as we're going to get ready to go green for the start of the third and final stage here in the Brickyard 400. Bubba Wallace having a bit of a rough run. I can confirm that 23 team is definitely doing a lot back in the shop in terms of R&D, so you're going to see some improvements come out of that team relatively soon now. As you see, Truex actually gets ahead of Kyle Busch on the pit lane, so he'll restart P2 now as the third and final stage is underway. Denny Hamlin, he's led every lap so far in this race, and as we start lap 28 of 40, he needs to lead 13 more to go and get a full sweep of this race by leading every lap, winning every stage, and of course winning the Brickyard 400 here as we come through down towards turns 2. In real life, Hamlin has had some chances in the past few years to win the Brickyard 400, but unfortunately he's kind of given them away, most notably the one where he blew a right front tire while leading with less than 10 laps to go. Felt so bad for him when that happened as a Hamlin fan myself now, as we get right to the back of Martin Truex Jr., clearing Briscoe, so immediately I lunge to the inside of the 19 as we go into turn 3, knowing that we have to get on the attack here at the start of the stage. That's when we know we have our greatest chance there, as I got into the 19's left run. Fortunately, nothing really happened out of that now as we exit turn 4. I'm pushing way up the track, and I have to get way out of the throttle to make sure I do not knock that right side of the car down by hitting the wall. So that definitely costed us some time now, as we unfortunately put Truex in a bad position where he has now been under attack from the 14 of Briscoe, as well as the 41 of Custer, the 36 of David Reagan, and the 4 of Kevin Harvick, all right there with him as we go down into turn 2. And unfortunately, Apparently, that gap opened up between myself, Kyle Busch, and Denny Hamlin after we had to really check up on the exit of turn four, and I was a little bit concerned about how hard it was going to be able to close up that gap to the two fastest cars here today in the Brickyard 400. Now, as we do barely have that draft from Kyle Busch, but it's not enough to close up to the back of him as we go into turn three. Now, as I clipped the apron just a little bit, but it does not really affect us, fortunately, but we need to minimize the mistakes, but unfortunately, we come to lap 30 through turn three, and I make the same mistake. I barely clipped the apron, but fortunately, it wasn't really enough to where it really affected us, but you can see now, I do not have the draft as we exit turn four, but we have opened up the gap between myself and fourth place as we just came off of our fastest lap of the race at this point, but you can just see I don't have the draft at this point with nine laps to go, so the concerns building about our chances to have a victory or a defending victory here now after we got this win last season in the career mode in our rookie season now is going to turn two with a caution. Comes out with nine laps to go. Everybody going to be staying out here. Honestly, I didn't know what to think about this one because I know we still don't necessarily have race-winning speed. So definitely know that we are going to have to pass Denny Hamlin within the first two laps of this restart if we're going to have any chance at all of winning this race. That's really what it all banks on now is we're going to get ready to go green for what could be the final restart of the day here in the Brickyard 400. Denny Hamlin, Kyle Busch, myself, Chase Briscoe, the top four. Truex has fallen outside of the top five now as it was JGR, 1, 2, 3, 4, most of the race here now as we are back underway on lap 35 of 40, six laps remain. Chase Briscoe on my outside. What an incredible rookie season it has been for Chase Briscoe here in the career mode, and he continues to show some strength now with a strong run here today in the Brickyard. Now as we're side by side with Kyle Busch, knowing I need to clear him if I'm going to have a chance to pass Hamlin within these first couple laps as we exit turn two. I'm going to get a little bit aggressive and pinch the 18. Some contact there between myself and Kyle, and he has to get out of the throttle. David Reagan looks to the inside of Kyle Busch now as we go down this back straight away, but unfortunately no chance to lunge to the inside of Hamlin into turn three, so I know that we're running out of time very quickly as we come through with the center of three. The car slides just a little bit, but it's not bad enough to where it's out of my control, so I'm still confident here as we come through out of turn four, knowing I need to stick with Hamlin as much as I can, but we wash up towards the wall and we need to make a move here if possible as we go down this front straightaway. This could be our last opportunity right here to have a chance of winning the Brickyard 400 back-to-back now as we go down towards turns one, but it's not going to be enough now as I go into the corner way too hard there, almost into the back of Hamlin. I slide up the track and leave the door wide open for Kyle Busch, and now he's going to go by on the inside. Way too deep. I underestimated the effect of the draft there, guys. That was all on me. There, you heard it on the radio. I just underestimated the effect of the draft into turn one. I just went way too deep and unfortunately nearly cleaned out Hamlin. And now we come through on lap 36. You can see how loose the car was at this point through turn three. I'm struggling there after hitting that apron. So now I felt like we just completely threw any chance right there away as we exit turn four, realizing the mistakes I have made have put us now down here in this position where we have no chance of even getting into the mix as we come through to three laps to go in the Brickyard 400. Logano now in P4. We've had some run-ins with him recently, and I was hoping that he was not going to be able to run us down, but when I wasn't making mistakes, I was actually able to stay comfortably ahead of these drivers and open up the gap just a little bit now as we come through, approaching two laps to go through turns where you can see the power slide right there through the center of the corner as Alex Bowman in the 48 car finds himself up in that fourth position as I clip the apron again out of turn four as we come through to two laps to go. Hamlin and Kyle Busch P1 and P2 is Bowman. He continues to actually close that gap a little bit to myself as we come through down into turn four. Denny Hamlin looking for the very first Brickyard 400 win of his career now as he is no stranger to winning crown jewel races as he's won multiple Daytona 500s now as we come through down this front straightaway. Denny Hamlin starts the final lap. Kyle Busch second, chasing him in case he makes a mistake or has a mechanical issue as we go down into turn one for the final time here on the Brickyard 400, and we're washing up the track now into the safer barrier. We smash the wall now and damage the right side of the car. Bowman, Custer, and a whole bunch of other cars, including our teammate Martin Truex Jr., are all going to go by on the inside on this final lap.
I cannot believe I just did that. I'm so sorry, guys.
There you heard the radio transmission once again from myself. A little bit of frustration on the radio that time now as we're trying to hang on now to the top 10 as we come through down into turn 3 on this final lap in the Brickyard 400 as we have completely given away any chance we had. As we exit turn 3, they're clipping the outside wall again barely as we dive down into turn 4. And Denny Hamlin, though, leads the way down the front straightaway. I have to get out of the throttle, allowing Elliott to get to the back of me. But Hamlin wins the Brickyard 400. Elliott now to the left rear quarter panel side by side coming to the line now as we push him down a little bit, but we get through to get P10 here in the Brickyard 400. But the disappointment sets in as it just did not quite go our way today. We had some opportunities there, and you know, when we had a chance to pass Hamlin, I went way too deep into the corner and gave the position away to Kyle Busch. Then I hit the wall, everything just kind of all on me in that one now, as you see the rest of the finishing order on your screen. Chastain actually didn't have terrible luck today, so he finished in the top 15, as he's had such a rough season. Now is Almirola and Blaney, your two DNS. We know Almirola, he's going to RPM next season in the career mode, as he's getting replaced at Stuart Haas by Matt DiBenedetto. But as always, if you guys enjoyed this episode, you do know what to do. And now we're going to check out the point standings now, as we do have a truck race coming, I think I said there in the next episode. So that will be back with a subscriber in the truck for our team now. As you see the Xfinity playoff standings, Haley currently the last driver in, and now we're going to check out the Cup Series standings now, as I didn't bother showing the trucks because we haven't had any truck races. But there's the Cup Series side. We still lead the playoff standings, but Hamlin closes the gap in the regular season standings, and there's a lot of playoff points on the line for that top seed in the regular season standings. Hopefully we can win that, but I will see you guys in the next one for Kentucky. Thank you for watching, and have yourselves a great day, everybody.